Hugh Herr is one of the most amazing success stories of our time. His ability to overcome obstacles and turn his life around is phenomenal. Herr is relatable and meaningful to so many different kinds of people. He relates to the athlete, the humanitarian, the scholar, those who have struggled, and those who have persevered. Additionally, he was born in Lancaster, PA, only 2 hours from State College. Herr is an amazing athlete and has been all of his life. He started climbing when he was 7 and quickly reached great heights. At a mere 7 years of age, Herr climbed to the top of Mount Temple, an 11,000-foot cliff. By 17 years old, he was regarded as one of the best climbers in the United States. It was at this age that he experienced a seemingly unrecoverable tragedy.
I was 17 years old. My climbing partner and I traveled to North Conway, New Hampshire to ascend Mount Washington. And as we climbed, the conditions got worse and worse. We ended up in blizzard whiteout conditions without a compass and map, with wind speeds that are constantly changing direction. We attempted to turn around and reverse our direction, but failed to do so. I was certain we would not see the light of day. The average depth of snow was to the waist, sometimes to the chest. We lasted nearly 4 days, but we could no longer walk. We had severe frostbite and hypothermia. And then a person was out snowshoeing and came upon our snow cave. We were taken to Littleton Hospital in New Hampshire. We were, upon arrival, immediately treated for hypothermia. Gangrene was slowly moving up my body, and as this progressed, my legs became more and more grotesque. My doctor asked me whether I wanted them removed, and I finally said yes. I awoke from the surgery and I looked down, and the bed sheets were over my legs, and you could see where the leg ended. I was shocked and I just started wailing.
Most people would just focus on trying to get back to normal life after such an incident, but Hugh Herr would not settle for that. He was dissatisfied with his limited abilities, even just walking or running, and would not accept that he could not climb anymore. The athlete decided to design his own prostheses specifically for climbing. He made many different designs that allowed him to stand on small rock edges, stick in small crevices, climb vertically up ice, or even adjust his height. Soon enough, he reached his former skill level and quickly surpassed it, being the first major amputee to perform at the elite level. How did Hugh Herr even have the ability to just design his own prostheses, you might ask? According to him, he actually started out as a terrible student. He attended trade school during his high school days and had little interest or motivation in his studies. After his injury, he gained a newfound dedication to education. Herr attended local Millersville University, where he received a bachelor's degree in physics. He went on to earn a master's degree in mechanical engineering from MIT, followed by his PhD in biophysics from Harvard. After school, Herr became a professor of media arts and sciences at MIT, heading the institution's biomechatronics group. This man went from having minimal academic success to becoming a professor and leader at the world's top-ranked university for engineering, as the result of enduring a life-altering accident that would have debilitated most people. He also founded his own prosthetics company called Biom in 2007. They produced the first power foot-ankle bionic limb in the world, and to this day, it is the only lower limb prosthesis with powered propulsion for enhanced mobility. The company was eventually renamed Bionics and bought by Ottobock. On top of that, he has over 60 published works and 10 patents. The injury caused Herr to experience the hardships and lack of resources for amputees. He now dedicates himself to helping others and improving humanity. For example, Dr. Herr met with Boston bombing victim Adrian Hoslett Davis, used his resources, and worked with his team and dancers to design a prosthesis that would allow Herr to dance again.
Ladies and gentlemen, please allow me to introduce Adrian Hoslett Davis, her first performance since the attack. She's dancing with Christian Leitner.
she displays during this dance show the monumental impact he had on her life and the lives of many others. The ability to make other people's lives better is very important to her. Not only does he work hard and devote resources to this, but he is grateful that he can do the work.
I have the power, I have the resource to help people. And I can witness it during my own lifetime. How beautiful is that?
Her also helped service many wounded soldiers who gave their bodies for the United States by helping them get their lives back and regain some normalcy in their routines. When his company designed the Power Foot Ankle Bionic Limb, half of the users were soldiers. They have reimbursements for veterans, wounded soldiers, and workplace injuries, but are trying to help get funding for as many people as possible. He is even working on designing an exoskeleton to take stress off the bodies of soldiers and allow them to move more quickly and easily. Cue Her's story of perseverance goes further yet beyond his ability to climb at an incredible level after his injury and design his own prostheses. It speaks directly to his mindset and perspective. Dr. Her said that given the opportunity, he would not want his legs back. He believes that the technological substitutions are an improvement because they give him abilities that he would not otherwise have and will not deteriorate with his age. Her does not see disabilities in people or believe that they have imperfections, but rather a chance to improve technology. He seeks to use his hard work and designs to improve humanity.
I reason that a human being can never be broken. Technology is broken. Technology is inadequate. This simple but powerful idea was a call to arms to advance technology for the elimination of my own disability and ultimately to the disability of others.
Hugh Her's determination is extremely admirable and displays the message that our experiences do not define what we can achieve, but our hard work and dedication can help us achieve anything.